that's the vehicle we used to get here from our hotel, which is Ohia Jungle Resort. But then it looks like we need to walk at least 16 kilometers all the way in. So the ticket is like 12,000 for two people. So you can say like 6,000 for an individual. So I think the road goes all the way in, and then we got our hotel mates also with us.
It's a 9 kilometer walk.
So the van took us just 3 kilometers inside the Horton Plains Park. So it's about around I think 16 kilometers I would say, or something less than that. But I won't be filming all of it because of the battery constraints. So we'll be just covering whatever is important or whatever is interesting to look at. Okay, but you can get a view of this place, which is okay. But then I didn't get your name.
Martin.
Okay, so
that's yours.
My name is Vicky.
Vicky. Yeah.
Okay, so we are the hotel mates.
Yeah, I've got the game.
The water is pretty clean, isn't it? If you bring a plastic bottle, I think you can just fill it up. But then what happens is they check your bag at the entrance and then remove all the single-use plastics. In case if you have the cover or something else, they just remove it and replace it with a normal cover so that you don't throw it around here. It's tough to clean such a long, large amount of area, isn't it? So it's very pretty silent, but then we have to go at least some 9 kilometers and come back to the point where we started and then take another route from there. So I'll just see if I can find some falls or something in between for you to see. It looks like we have walked maybe 2 or 3 kilometers from where the van dropped us, but then we have reached a place where there is something called a viewpoint. So it goes all the way up. I don't know where it is, but then I just want to show you how it looks from here. It's a bit sunny in the early morning. You can see how it looks grand, isn't it? And mind you, there are leopards here. It is mentioned in the board that there are leopards here. So it's not a dull and boring task, and there is a river kind of thing flowing there. Perhaps we can go there first and then maybe climb to viewpoint somewhere up there, if possible. Okay.
Dress up under there.
அண்டர்வேர் இருக்கான்னு பார்க்கறேன். என்ன எப்படி மாத்துறது?
ஏய் வேணாம் வேணாம், அங்க நின்னு நம்ம அவங்களை ஒரு போட்டோ எடுத்து சொல்ல வேணாம்னா நம்ம அதெல்லாம் கவர் பண்ண முடியாது.
Just got into some bushy path, which adds to the experience. In Horton Plains National Park, you can hear the rivers, the flowing noise all over the place. That means it's not far away at any time. Then it's full of bushes, and then you can see these trails, and the river is somewhere there hidden between the bushes. So I'd say since we started early in the morning, it's not very tired. But then if you start in the evening, you would get a bit more tired because of the sunlight draining your energy down. So it's better to start in the early morning, I would say. Okay. So I just wanted to show you this one, which we just went earlier, 5 minutes ago, the water thing. So it comes from all the way there and then it flows into a pond kind of place. I don't know whether, I think it goes that way, into a small channel. So it's beautiful. So you can see the path all the way. Very nice, isn't it? Okay, cool. Hey, there's one more path there, I don't know where it goes. But then as of now, I'll just continue with this path and see what I can do next. Okay, finally we can see some sunlight, the sun going up. The fact that it rained yesterday means that you can see a lot of water flowing like this, small patches of you can see it closely. Then you can jump over it, it's not that high. And you can also see the main water channel flowing just parallel to us. I don't know if you can see it, but it's nearby. So all in all, you can see there is a little bit or more amount of water flowing somewhere nearby, keeping all the species alive in this part of the place, where human habitation is limited to touristic experience in these trails. You don't know, people don't go there unless you are a forest ranger, for some specific reason you are asked to do. There's not much you can do. I think you can see the water there. Can you? Oh, just perhaps we are just a kilometer away from the Baker's Hill, Baker's waterfall. So I can hear some noise, but I don't know where it is. But just wanted to, that's the trail there. That's the trail where we have to walk. But I just thought I'll just walk off the track to show you this beautiful pond, if that's what you call it. You can see the pond, it's flowing from all the way there, and then it's going there. Perhaps it falls down somewhere. But then you can see this beautiful marshlands Cool, isn't it? Nice. And it becomes even more nicer in this sunny environment. So it's going up, little bit up and little bit down, a little bit up and little bit down. So all the way, it's going like that. Okay. See, it's again, it's going down. Perhaps after this, again, it will go a little bit up. So it's a different experience in the sense that usually don't walk in this kind of environment. You usually go by bus or scooter or some vehicle. You don't walk unless you are native to this place. So this gives you a nice experience, isn't it? Which you don't want to miss if you want to come to Sri Lanka. Just on the view on the opposite side is amazing, and I cannot help but make a shout from here to see if I can anyone can hear from here, isn't it? You can see the nice place. Woo! It's echoing from that mountain and then to this mountain and comes back to me. It's beautiful, isn't it? Okay, we'll shout this side to see how it looks. Okay, I think this is how they would have communicated in the past. There's no phone, nothing. If you want to speak to someone on who is standing on someone who is standing on this mountain, if you want to talk to someone who is standing there, I think this should be the only way of communication, isn't it? There's not much you can do except for shouting, which is a natural mode of communication to show you at least where you are. At least to show that you are alive and kicking. Okay, it looks like another interesting path down there. Beautiful, beautiful. Worth the 12,000 rupees we paid for the day, isn't it? We don't want to miss this. If you come to Sri Lanka, this is the PSD resistance. So you have to spend a lot of days in Waravalia, Ella, and Horton Park. Horton Park. So otherwise you would miss a lot, like us. So this should be the motivation to come for the next time, for a longer trip with a good backup, isn't it? Okay, we have come to the Baker's Fall. So it should be the most beautiful part. I think you can already hear the sound of the waterfalls. And I can already feel it, the vibration and all that. Can't wait to go inside and see. Okay, so rushing. Here it is. Coming all the way. Beautiful, few more steps. Woo! Ta-da! I think that's the end. You can go there and see. But you can see the waterfall furious, making noise. But we can go nearby. But that's one hell of a risk you want to take. You might slip and jump over the fall, which is not safe at all, isn't it? Woo! Here it is for you. And the forest background, that's the path you came by. And here it is, you can see. I don't know, I think we can go down. Okay, I'll go down. Woo-hoo-hoo. Beautiful. But there's no way to go and touch the water. Cool. Already you can see me sweating all the way. Cool. You find one or two bridges like this where there's a clean, crystal clean water flowing down. Few places you find water like this, very clean. And it's like a paradise for animals, which including humans. Animals after all, sometimes. Okay, you can even stand there and have a sip of water if you want. But then I already had in another place and then not very thirsty now. Okay, cool. It goes all the way inside. Perhaps to the place where the waterfalls was there. Okay, so I think it becomes a tricky path again. Okay, even at this time it is sunny, but then you can see the fog, mist and all in between flowing around like water all the place. It looks as if they have started a fire, but then it's just the fog. Then think of how it will look the early morning. It will look as if you can't even see the person standing nearby. So that will be a quite a nice experience. But then they open only at 6 a.m. So that's not much you can do. Okay, more tourist. Looks like we are up for the topmost spot. Okay, someone has poured milk. It looks like that, isn't it? Cool. Cool. Just a nice view. See this? Full of white all the way. If you fall down, you can't see yourself. Shameful way to die. So I'll just go on the opposite side. Okay. So we went like this and then we are here. So we'll go back. So at least we are more than half the distance. And there is one more route where we can go from the center to it looks like it's 11 kilometers. So we'll take that as well. For all the adventures we want to do in Sri Lanka, this should be the PSD resistance, isn't it? Okay. Another nice path, which looks like a village road. But then what we saw now is the greater world's end. So after maybe few kilometers, there's a mini world's end. Maybe I think it has the same view, but then not as magnificent as that place. So we'll just go there. We're almost over half the distance. And then we'll reach the point where we started at Horton Plains. Okay, we are almost here at the mini world's end. I think it's just the same view. Bit less magnificent than the one we saw at Greater World's End. Full of snow. One view at a time. Perhaps we should go that way. And I think we'll reach the point where we started. At the Horton Plains. Which should not be far away. Before taking some rest and going somewhere else. This track is perhaps the last part of the loop before heading to the Horton Plains starting point. But then we may also go to another place which is just 11 kilometers from the starting point. But I'll put it as a separate video. So if you want to see that video, you might subscribe using the button below the video. And thanks for watching. If you see some board which shows at the starting point, I'll show you after this, or else this will be the end of this video. Thanks. Back to where we started. So you might have thought the video has ended, but then it hasn't, because it is just now I reached the place where we started for Horton Plains National Park. That's where we started. And then on time. And then we might go somewhere else to some other path now. But then for this video, just this much. Just stay tuned for my other videos about Sri Lanka. Thanks for watching. Thank you. Thank you for avoiding single-use plastics in Horton Plains. Okay, here it is.